The information and graphical content used in this video is just for education purpose. Fairy Circles of Namibia, a largely unexplained phenomenon, parts of the Namib are populated by peculiar grass ring patches called fairy circles, puzzlingly scattered across the desert's cape. These curious, naturally occurring circles not only appear to be evenly spaced and sized, but they also never overlap. It's as if the desert's flawless complexion has been marred by a baffling, widespread rash, as millions of eerie crater-like pockmarks dominate the dusty terrain. Fascinatingly, there are only two places on the entire planet where these seemingly magical circles exist. Originally, it was believed that these strange bald spots only occur in Namibia's ancient Namib Desert. However, in 2014, fairy circles were discovered in yet another desert environment in Western Australia. Some say it looks like the desert has chickenpox, but I like to think of it as an enormous cinnamon-colored sheet of pastry that is covered in the repetitive, round perforations of a cookie cutter. No one knows, with absolute scientific certainty, why these cookie cutter patterns exist in just two of the world's deserts, and nowhere else on Earth. Scientists, ecologists, entomologists, botanists, travelers and local cultures alike each have their own theories, many of them laughable, and the strange puzzle continues to baffle and bewilder onlookers from around the world. There are countless hypotheses, and the debate is long-standing. True to their namesake, are these circles formed by hand-holding fairies dancing gleefully to ring around the rosy? Is the desert secretly inhabited by underground fire-breathing dragons? Have dust-bathing ostriches formed the recurring patterns with their feathered frolics in the sand? Or is it a reserved sleeping spot for Namibia's national animal? In local myths, the bare, red circles fringed with grass are footprints of the gods, or patches of land once poisoned by the breath of a subterranean dragon. But even among scientists who strive for more convincing theories, the curious, repetitive patterns have proved hard to explain. If you ask the local people, they have their own cultural beliefs too. Some see the fairy circles as a gift from heavenly deities, while others believe they are God's footprints in the sand. Or, better yet, are they simply the work of unexplained UFOs? Cue the Unsolved Mysteries theme song. There are two far more probable and realistic explanations for these puzzling desert formations. One school of thought insists that the ominous circles are most likely the result of neighboring armies of underground termite colonies, duking it out regularly for territory and nutrients. The other school claims that the fairy rings are caused by desert vegetation, competing for scarce water and nutrients in the soil. A meeting of the minds, recent scientific research actually suggests that it is a combination of both dueling termite colonies and competing vegetation. Whether you believe in frolicking fairies or intergalactic intruders, or you support the more down-to-earth scientific explanations, the long-standing fairy circle debate remains an unsolved mystery. We love a bit of magic and mystique, and perhaps what we love most about these weird and wonderful fairy circles is that they are the perfect size and setting for romantic, lantern-lit dinners for two under the stars. Since fairy circles became the focus of scientific study, researchers have proposed a host of ways by which the bare disks of soil may form. One idea points the finger at underground termites that engineer the landscape above their heads. Another proposal claims the patterns, which can grow to 25 meters wide, arise from natural competition between desert grasses. In the latest effort to nail the answer, ecologists at Princeton University turned to computer models. To start with, they ran simulations to mimic the impact on desert grasses of termites building colonies underground. Sand termites in the Namib Desert eat the roots of low-lying vegetation, meaning more moisture for them and dead patches on the ground above. In the simulations, the dead zones were confined to patches created when neighboring colonies of a similar size came up against one another and settled on a border between their territories. The termites start with their own mound and go out and forage, said Karina Tarnita at Princeton. If they find a smaller colony, they simply kill it and expand their own territory. But if they run into a colony that is about the same size, they cannot do that and end up with a boundary where there's permanent conflict, but not a full-blown war. But the termites did not explain the patterns completely. Tarnita next built a computer model that simulated the warring underground termites, as well as the natural competition that arises between desert greenery. If a plant takes root in the desert, it can provide moisture and shade for others nearby, and so give them a helping hand. But as the plant grows, its roots spread out to draw in more water, making it harder for more distant plants to find water themselves. The researchers who report their findings in Nature do not claim to have an explanation for how every fairy circle forms. But when they combine the two theories, the patterns that arise more closely match those seen in the desert, Tarnita said. We get a much more complete description of the patterns, she said. One of the most striking things about nature is that despite the complexity of all of its interactions and the many processes that act simultaneously, sometimes, and more often than we expected, you find these amazing regularities, she added. We wanted to know how can these messy things results in so much beauty and order on such enormous scales. Until recently, fairy circles were only known in the Namib Desert, but in 2014, scientists reported that they had spotted similar patterns in Western Australia's Pilbara region. Aerial photographs revealed them to be nearly identical to those found in Namibia, despite being so far away.